1,600 nursing home employees plan a strike, and CVS Health says they are well positioned to serve LTC with future COVID-19 vaccines. This and more next.
You're watching LTC News with Dane Henning.
Welcome to CNA TV Long-Term Care News. I'm Dane Henning. Today is Wednesday, August 12th, 2020. To stay in on long-term care news, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Detroit area nursing home operators could be facing a significant staffing shortage soon after 1,600 staff announced plans to strike later this month. Employees at 18 facilities in the Metro Detroit area said they are planning to strike on August 17th, citing unfair labor practices and unsafe conditions for both staff and residents, SEIU Healthcare Michigan announced on Friday. They're asking operators to provide adequate PPE and increased wages for workers and to take responsibility for COVID-19's toll on facilities. More than 2,000 Michigan nursing home residents and staff had died from the coronavirus as of August 6th, according to data from the state. Dozens of Illinois operators averted strikes at 64 nursing homes in early May after they increased wages by 24% in a deal with SEIU Healthcare. One operator noted that it was the largest wage increase for staff in its history. Long-term care facilities that receive pharmacy services from CVS Health should have sufficient access to a COVID-19 vaccine once it is ready, executives stated last week. Quote, we are well positioned to administer COVID-19 vaccines once they become available through our community presence as well as on-site with our return ready and long-term care solutions, said Larry Merlo, president and CEO of CVS Health, Omnicare's parent company, during a second quarter earnings call. Drug makers have stated that a vaccine could be ready for distribution at the end of this year or early 2021. President Donald Trump has also previously suggested that long-term care residents and staff would be expected to get top priority once it becomes available. CVS executives also highlighted the company's recently launched diagnostic testing program for seniors in long-term care facilities. The program uses point-of-care rapid testing. Quote, through the end of July, we administered approximately 2 million COVID-19 tests, with the vast majority scheduled digitally as a result of our highly adaptable consumer-centric digital health strategy, Merlo said. Executives also noted that the pandemic has substantially affected Omnicare and the company's long-term care presence overall. The company reported that the total revenues for its retail LTC segment increased by 1% for the quarter, but the increases were partially offset by continued reimbursement pressure, the impact of recent generic introductions, lower front store revenues, and decreased long-term care prescription volume. This has been your long-term care news update. Everyone have a wonderful week, and I'll see you on Wednesday.